Good morning students, welcome to English language class and today we will read chapter number 8 and in this chapter we will learn use of many, much, some, any, a lot of, a few, a little. Now look at this picture of cafeteria and let's read its description. There are many children in the cafeteria. Some are eating sandwiches. A few girls are eating ice cream. A lot of people are enjoying snacks like idlis and dosa. There isn't any person who is not eating anything. Now children, you might have noticed the highlighted words in the above sentences. The words many, some, a few, a lot of and any. They tells us about the number of things. We use a, an, some, a few, many, not many, a lot of, a lot, with the countable nouns that can be counted. For example, I need a few books from the store. We have many boxes. So these are the countable nouns. We use any and some with uncountable and plural nouns to mean a limited quantity or a number of things. For example, there were a bowl and some corn flakes on the table, but there wasn't any milk. So here, the word any and some, these are used with uncountable and plural nouns. Some conflicts, that is uncountable, and any milk is also denoting uncountable noun that cannot be counted. We use any in negative sentences and in questions also. For example, there isn't any sugar in the bowl. So here, any is using for the negative statement. This means no. Have you got any butter? So here, any used in the form of question. Some and any can be used with countable nouns also. We use any or some when we cannot or do not wish to specify the exact amount of something. When the exact amount of anything is not known to us, then we use some or any. For example, she has some pins but don't know exactly how many pins. Can I borrow some paper clips? Again, when the exact number is not known to us, we use some or any. Any is used in negative sentences and also in questions. As we have already learned just now, we haven't got any buns from the market. Here, any means no. Are there any biscuit in this jar? So here, any is used in the form of question. It is also used in questions. Now let's learn the use of many, much, a lot of. We use many with countable nouns in plural form. Let's see with an example. She has many dolls in the box. It is also a countable noun as well as plural noun. We use much with uncountable nouns. Much is commonly used in negative sentences and in questions. For example, how much water do you need? This is used with a question. We don't get much rain here. So here, much is used in a negative form, means no. We use a lot of and lots of with both countable and uncountable nouns. They are used to express large quantities of something. Let's see an example. A lot of paintings were damaged in the fire. It is telling you about a large quantity of paintings that were damaged in the fire. Farid likes a lot of butter on his toast, also denoting large quantity of butter. Now, a little, little, a few, few. A little and little are both used with uncountable nouns. When we use a little, that means there is a small amount of something. And when we use little, that means there is not enough or almost none. Let's see an example. There was a little water in my bottle. It's showing you the small amount. So I shared some with my friend. In sentence number two, there was a little water in my bottle, so I came home thirsty. Again, showing small amount or small quantity. A few and few are used with countable nouns. A few is more in quantity than few. When we use a few, we means that there is a small number of something. And when we use few, we mean a very smaller number, almost none. Let's see an example. Since a few students came to school, the teacher did not teach anything important. Here, it is showing you a few, small in number. A few students came to school, so the classes were empty. So here, few meaning very small in number, almost none. Now look at the chart given here. You have to see and learn how we use some, any, a few, a little, much, many, and a lot of. Some used with plural countable nouns. Some used with uncountable nouns also. Much used with plural countable nouns. Strong and used with uncountable noun is a correct one. So here, children, the formula or the rules are given to you. You have to read it and you have to learn these rules. Use of any, few, little, much, many, a lot of, from your book. Now let's do some exercise. Now your first exercise is read the sentences and tick the correct word from the bracket. You have two options for each sentence. One is the correct one and then you have to pick it. Tick the right one. Now let's do some exercise based on the chapter. Now first one is tick the correct word from the bracket. First one is dash learning is a dangerous thing. Less learning or little learning? The right option is little learning is a dangerous thing. Second one, my father is a man of dash words. The correct option is few words. Third one, the leader did not have any time for his people. In this way, children, you can complete rest of the sentences using the correct correct form of the word. Now, next one. It is a fill in the blanks. Children, you have to fill it with using some or any. Dash girls wanted to eat the apples on the tree, but there wasn't any. So here, some will be written. Some girls wanted to. When we don't know the exact number of girls, we always use some to denote the quantity. So here, some girls, when the number of girls is not known to us, some girls wanted to eat the apple, but there wasn't any, means there was no apple on the tree. Any used in negative form here. Second one is, do you have dash news about him? Any news? So here, any used in question. Can I have dash tea? Can I have some tea? And now in this way, you can complete rest of the sentences with using some and any. Now again, come to the next exercise, that is also of fill in the blanks. You have to complete the sentences using few, a few, little, or a little. There are a few customers, very little in number, waiting for the books. He put dash sugar in his tea. A little, very small in quantity. A little. Dash people turned off for the functions last night due to heavy rain. Few people. Few means almost none. Now in this way, you can complete the fill in the blanks with using a few, little, or a little. Now children, I hope you have understood the chapter very well. Thank you, children.